इच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छसुच्छाय आयाजित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बूमद्रिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्युतो नखाः. सो वी आर लुकिङ्ग् एट् अवस्थाभेदात् आनन्त्यं नवत्वं. सो अवस्था देशकालादि विशेषैरपि जायते आनन्त्यमेव वाच्यस्य शुद्धस्यापि स्वभावतः. जस्ट् प्रिफर् टु हाव् द बुक् आल्सो आन् हेण्ड्. Avastha, this is the karika we are dealing with, and in that darshitameva cha, we looked at some of the Kumarasambha examples. Darshitameva cha etat vishamabana leelayam nacha tesham ghatate avadihi nacha te drishyate kathamapi unaruktaha ye vibhramaha priyanam arthava sukavi vaninam. So something that we have we know is there is no avadhi, there is no limit to what a poet can say. Or priyanam vibramaha, the beautiful graces of ladies, the vibrama of a lady is also, there is no avadhi to it, there is also no punaruktatvam, there is no repetition of it. The same way sukavi vani namapi, the for the speech of great poets also, there is no avadhi, there is no limit to it, nor is there any repetition. So ayam cha aparaha avastha bedaha, we have to start from here, right? So ayam cha, ayam aparaha cha avastha beda prakaraha yat achetananam sarvesham chetanam dvitiyam rupam abhimanitva prasiddham himavad gangadinam. Another way of avastha, avastha is a situation or how the person is, right? So there chetana achetananam api chetanatva vyavaharaha. There is, we have seen the two forms of achetana vastu. Everywhere in Bharata Desham, we find that trees, there is a vanadevata. If you look at rivers, river, every river is a devata swarupam for us. Every mountain has a devata swarupam. Any achetana vastu, even books, even the you know, vadyam, veena, geeta, adi vadyam, everything has a devata swarupam there for us. We see divinity in every aspect of the object that is there in us. So just to give us that respect things that have been given to you, that sort of a culture has to be inculcated in people. That is the idea behind giving achetana daivatvam for all the achetana vastu. Respect what you have. Right? So yad achetana achetananam sarvesham api chetanam dvitiyam rupam, it is the second form of all the insentient beings. Abhimanitva prasiddham, abhimanitvam is where you feel that there is an atma swarupam for all of that. That's why he starts off with the himavat varnana in Kumarasambhavam. He starts with the asti uttarasyam dishi devatatma himalayo nama. Devatatma, devatam atma. Atmani devata swarupam api vartate tatra. So you have a physical form of mountain and another devata swarupam also. This similarly Ganga. I just took one example from Adishankara Bhagavatpada's Ganga Stotram, where he points out both aspects of Ganga, the Chetanatvam and the Achetanatva Vyavahara. Patitodharini Janhavi Gange, Khandita Girivara Mandita Bhange, Khandita Girivaram, that shows her Achetanatvam. It is a river that flows, Ganga. She cuts across mountains and at the same time Mandita Bhange, she also ornaments those Girivara, the great mountains. Patita Uddharini, she again uplifts us. Patitanam Uddharini sa, Papakritanam tatra gatva snanam kurmaha cheta, then it is lifts us, uplifts us from this papam. It is right. So as a river, she also does that. The same, if you look at the flip side of the devata swarupam, chetana swarupam, Bhishma janani he munivara kanye patita nivarini tribhuvana dhanye, which is looked upon as a dhanya, a fortunate person by the end, all three worlds, everybody, because Vishnu padochita devi Shankara pranavallabhava, no, something else marandu vedutu. her utpatti sthanam is Vishnupadam, and from there she came to Shiva's thalam. So she is and then she also goes to Patalam, Tripathaga. She is praised in all three worlds, but at the same time Bhishma Janani, that is her devata swarupam, chetanatva swarupam, right? Munivara Kanya, she is the daughter of a sage, and she also came from Vishnupada Chuta. So there are two aspects. In the same way for Himavat Parvata, that he also says that tacha uchita chetana vishaya swarupa yojanaya upanibadhyamanam anyadeva sampatyate. At the appropriate places, if we are able to include the chetana vishayatvam in that swarupam, so chetana vishaya uchita, appropriately, swarupa yojanaya upanibadhyamanam, when we add that also to this, then there is a great beauty, anyadeva sampadyate, it becomes entirely different from what we know till now. So yatha kumara sambhave eva parvata swarupasya himavataha varnanam. Parvata swarupasya varnanam tu yam sarva shailah parikalpyavatsam, or you can say anantaratna prabhavasya yasya himam na saubhagya vilopi jatam. So he has a lot of, he is the uspattisthanam for anantaratna. At the same time, he has hima, hima, himanam, alayaha, saha. Himam na saubhagya vilopi jatam, yeko hi dosho, gunasan nipate, nivajjatindo, kiraneshwankaha. There are many, there are guhas in that. Each of those caves have ratnadeepam in it. And that ratnadeepam is, does not go away at all. So these sort of a description is there in the first sarga. At the same time, because it is devata swarupam, and he is also Giri Rajaha. He is the king of all the mountains. So a king has to have Chatra Chamaram. So the Chamaram is the first identification for him. I just took out a few shlokas to give that the beauty of that. So Langula Vikshepa Visarpishovaihi Itastatas Chandra Marichi Gauraihi Yasyartha Yuktam Giri Raja Shabdam Kurvanti Vala Vyajanais Chamaryaha. Chamari Mrigaha Santi Tatra. So these female deers, they have a nice tail, bushy tail. Langula Vikshepa Visarpishovaihi. They keep moving their tails up and down, and those tails are white in color. Not all deers are brown in color. So this is a type of Mruga that is found in Himavat Parvatam. And there, they are white in color, and the tails are also white. Chandra Marichi Gauraihi. It's as white as the moonlight. Yasyartha Yuktam Giriraja Shabdam Kurvanti. Giriraja Shabdam Artha Yuktam Kurvanti. Katham Bala Vyajanaihi. They keep doing that chamaram for Giriraja, for Himavan. And the word Giriraja becomes very appropriate. It is apt for Himavan. Just like a Raja who has all the chamaram and all that. Right? So both, most of the description in the first sarga, if you find, is only, even though he says Devatatma, the first few descriptions are only about how his physical form, Achetana Vastu. Then he marries Mena, he has Mainaka, Parvata as his son, and then Parvati is born to him. All of those give us Chetanatva Vishayam also. More than that, again when he describes Himavan in the sixth sarga, where he receives the Saptarishis, see, Shiva, we don't know his Utpatti. So who, he just thinks about the Saptarishis, and all of them descend in front of him and say, you know, he says, I want a favor from you. They say that, you know, just by mere thinking of us, you have done us a great grace. It's mutual there, both of them. So they help him, and someone has to go and ask for the kanya, right, from the groom's side. So Saptarishis go from the groom's side to Himavan to ask. So Himavan receives them. Tan argyana argyamadaya duratu pratyudyayo girihi. Girihi, Himavan, pratyudyayo, prati udyayo, he went towards them from duratu eva. He knew that they were all argya, they are fit for receiving an honor. So he just goes from far, he runs towards them. At the same time, he is also very sure of his steps. Namayan Sara Guruvihi Padanyasaihi Vasundhara. After that, the description of him is more beautiful. He says, Dhatu Tamra Adharaha. Dhatu is a mineral that is there in the Parvatam, which is the Achaitana Vastu, right? His lips are also Dhatu Tamram. It is red with that mineral powder. Pramshuhu, he's very tall. Himalayas is also very tall. Devadaru Brihad Bhujaha. So for the physical form, it is Devadaru Vriksham is like a bhujam, is like arms for the Parvatam. Whereas here, his Bahu Bhujam is like Devadaru Vat Brihat Bhujam. The Devata Swarupam, the Chaitana Swarupam is also, he compares it beautifully, both the physical form and the Parvata form. The Chaitanatvam and the Achaitana Swarupam is being described parallelly. Prakrityaiva Shila Uraskaha. Shiloraskaha. Shiloraskaha, his chest is very, is like a hard rock. So the Parvatam is made of hard rocks. He also has a very hard chest, in the sense is very strong. So Shila Iva Uraskaha. Uraha Yasya Saha. Suvyaktaha Himavaniti. It's very clear that he is Himavan. I love this shlokam very much. And then when he talks also, his opening statement to them, he says, Jangamam Praishya Bhave Vaha Sthavaram Charanankitam Vibhakta Anuragam Manye Dvi Rupam Api Me Vapuhu. Himavan says he has two rupams, right? Two Me Vapuhu Dvi Rupam. I have two forms of my Shariram. One is the Parvata Shariram, the other is the Devataswarupam. Now, Jangamam Rupam Tu Praishya Bhavena Vibhaktam Anugraham, Vibhakta Anugraham. So you have shown me grace by asking me to do something. You have come here for a request, right? To give my daughter. So Jangamam, Stavaram and Jangamam. Stavaram is the Achetanam and Jangamam is the Daivata, Chetana Vastu, Chetana Swarupam. So my Chetana Swarupam has been honored because you have come with a favor. My Achetana Vastu, that is the Himalayas itself, because you have stepped on it. Bhavatam Charanaihi Ankitam Iti Karanat Mama Sthavara Shariram Api Anugrihitam. It has been honored by your feet. So Punaha Saptarishi Priya Uktishu Chetana Tatswarupa Apekshaya. Pradarshitam tad apurvameva pratibhati. When we look at the Chetana description during the Saptarishi episode, that is also an apurvam. It's something very different from what people have, what other poets have done. You know, even if he has handled the same Himavat Parvatam, but his avastha is very different. In the first sargam, his avastha was an achetana vastu. In the sixth sarga, his avastha is as a devataswarupa, right? So prasiddha cha ayam satkavinam marga. It's a very popular methodology that great poets adopt. Idam cha prasthanam kavi vyutpattaye vishamabana leelayam saprapancham darshitameva. Anandavardhana has already given it in Vishamabana Leela in a great deal. So that poets can have that vyutpatti, they can have that confidence to, they have that creativity, they use their creativity to bring about anantyam for kavyam. You can create more and more poetry today. There are people writing about coronavirus today, right? So, poetry keeps coming in different forms based on Desha, Kala, etc. Next, he will talk about Desha, Kala also. So, Achetana Avastha Vedam, not only is Anantyam, there is also a Navatvam there. And Nanatvam, Anantyam is also there, Navatvam is also there, Apurvatvam is also there. For Achetana Vastu, not only for Chetanam, Achetana Vastu also can have Navatvam. Chetananam cha बाल्यादि अवस्थाभिः अन्यत्वं सत्कवीनां प्रसिद्धमेव. इट् इस् वेरि क्लियर् इन् ग्रेट् पोयट्स् रैटिङ्ग्स् दट् चेतनानां चेतन पोयट्स् केन् अचीव् एन् ओरिजिनालिटि. अन्यत्वं मीन्स् एन् ओरिजिनालिटि बै डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् द डिफ्रेण्ट् स्टेट्स् आफ् चेतनवस्तु लैक् बाल्यं यौवनम् एक्सेट्रा. A girl can be described in many states, right? Balyavastha, athava yavanavastha, vardhakyavastha, anything can be described there. Even within each and every avastha, each and every, even inside the balyavastha or yavanavastha, chetananam avastha bhede api, even within those, inside one of those state, there can be many subsidiary states. Avantara avastha bhedat nanatvam. So in the balya avastha also, you can say someone who is just beginning to enter into yavanam or someone who is still a kanya, there can be different subdivisions within that one division. Even in the yavanam, when we say mugdha, madhya and praudha, all of them are yuvati only. They're all in their yavana avastha only. Yet we distinguish between those naikas based on the avastha. So when you are describing a mugdha naika, it is one type of an avastha. So you can describe her differently. Even inside that mugdha naika, there is a khandita. So many different things are there, right? You have the ashtavidha naikas there. Each one is an avastha bhedam. Your dasharupakam will be more clear after reading this. How can you have different naikas? Can the same naika be the same? If I say this mukta, this is a mukta naika who is a proshita bhartrika, can she ever be a khandita naika? Yes, she can. Avastha bedat. That will clarify a lot of doubts that we have had till now. But only when you get, you know, doubts, then only this one will understand. If you start reading the Dvanyaloka from the beginning itself, it won't be so clear. Now things will become clear. Once you know that there are eight different naikas, now you know that it is avastha bedat eva tatra nanatvam. Avantara avastha bedat api, pratyekasyam avasthayam api avantara avasthaha bhavitum shakyaha. Yatha kumarinam kusumashara bhinna hridayanam anyasam cha. So you are taking one avastha, which is balyavastha or kumari, kumaram. In that Kumari avastha, Kusumashara Bhinna Hridayam and Anyasam. Kusumashara Abhinna Hridayam. Someone who is under the influence of love, who has been attacked by Manmatha, or someone who has not been attacked by him. Not under the influence of love. When you are under the influence of love, Kusumashara Bhinna Hridayanam api, tatra api, Vinitanam Avinitanam. Vinita, one who is disciplined, who is very nice and proper, prim and proper. Avinita, if there is a kamuka, she would rather go and approach him directly than wait for him to come and approach. So avinita, kulastri, akulastri, so many abhisarika, so many avastha vedas are there. Next, not only chetananam eva avastha vedam itina, achetananam api bhavanam avastha vedaha vartate. Katham, arambhadi avastha veda bhinnanam ekaikashaha swarupam uparivadhyamanam anantyameva upayati. Even for ajetana vastu, arambhadi avastha veda, arambhadi avastha, so I can talk about let's say sahakara or a mango bud, and just the advent of spring is there. Instead of describing the advent of spring, let's say, without even saying Vasantaratu, he's just describing a mango tree which doesn't have anything, or it has just started to give buds. And the next, he can also describe a mango tree with just buds, not just starting, but buds which are already there. Or the next stage, he can also describe a mango tree with flowers, or flowers which are going to fall down, depending on the state or depending on what he wants to describe. What is the prakaranam? If it is Bhartrihari who is trying to describe Vairagyam, he would rather describe that flowers falling down or fruits ripening and falling down or being whatever, you know, something that will give you the ephemeral nature of life. that jeevanam kadapi nasyed iti, you know, to give you that attitude. He can use whichever avastha he wants, depending on the prakaram. So achetananam bhavanam api bhava ityukte padarthanam achetana vastunam api arambadi avastha bheda bhinnanam ekaikashah each one to describe each swarupam upanibidyamanam. If you try to look at each and every stage of even the achetana vastu anantyameva upayati. You don't need to look at a tree from the ankuram, bijam, ankuram, and then a stalk, and then all these. You don't need to look at a tree also. You can even look at a flower's different stages. Yatha hamsanam ninadeshu yaihi kavaridaihi asajyate kujatam anyah kopi kashaya kantha luthanat agargaro vibhramaha te samprati akathora वारण वधु दंत अंकुर स्पर्धिनः निर्याताः कमलाकरेषु बिसिनी कंदाग्रिम ग्रंथयः बिसिनी कंद अग्रिम ग्रंथयः निर्याताः कमलाकरेषु 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 इन अ पॉन्ड विच इज like a akaram repository which is like a nidhi of kamalam which has a lot of lotuses which is supposed to have a lot of lotuses. It is a lotus pond. In that bisini kanda, there is a lotus stalk kandam tatra agrima granthi, in the foremost or in the topmost agrima granthi. Granthi vandu mudich, what is that called, a node. So there is a stalk and there are nodes, and in the topmost node the bud will start coming up, right? Mukulitam bhavati. So agrima granthayaha, those nodes are slowly showing, no, have come out. Niryataha, the top node of a bisini kandam, a lotus stalk in the lotus ponds, have slowly started coming out. Niryataha, how are they looking like? Samprati, now they have just started coming out, which is kathora varana vadhu danta ankura spardhinaha. That bud which has just started coming out of that node is not soft. It has not come out into a soft bud. When you touch it is soft, whereas when it is just the starting and it is in the node which is still connected to the node of the lotus stalk, it will be kathoram. It will be very hard to press, right? So kathoram. So it is spardhi, it is competing with the danta ankuram, it is competing with the small tusk teeth which is of the varana vadhu, of the she elephants. So it is, the lotus bulbs are like the tusks of young she elephants, which is very hard, right? And it is also very white in color. Apparently she elephants have whiter tusks than male elephants, I don't know. But yeah, now how are they, the before those, actually those buds are being eaten by the swans, and it just keeps those buds. So after it becomes a bud, the annapakshi hamsa eats it, kavalitaihi, it swallows it, and then because of swallowing that lotus buds, it has a very sweet voice. But those buds are now samprati, it is only in its arambha stage. That's the description of the shloka. So the annapakshi, in its voice, it's like it swirls that bud in its throat, and that is why it is able to emit a very sweet sound. So yaihi kavalitaihi, yaihi mukulaihi kavalitaihi kujatam hamsanam ninadeshu यः कोऽपि अन्यः अनिर्वचनीयः कः अपि कषाय कण्ठलुठनात् आगर्गरः विभ्रमः आसज्यते. अ ग्रेट् विभ्रमः, अ ग्रेट् ब्यूटी विच् इस् आगर्गर, इट् इस् लैक् अ सौण्ड्, यु नो दट् वेन् यु हेव् हनी, दट् हनी गोस् अण्ड् स्टेस्, इट् कोट्स् द थ्रोट् एण्ड् इट् गिव्स् यू अ वेरि sweet sound, or it just clarifies the throat in a manner. So you just keep swirling it like gargling. So kashaya kanta is two meanings. One is red color throat. So swans can have a red throat. I've not seen a swan which is red throated. So the other meaning is sweet voice. So Kashaya Kantha, a voice which is very sweet, has been made even more sweet because it is lutanam. That bud is going and swirling inside that Kantha and making it come out with a new beautiful sound. So Anyaha Koopi Vibramaha Ninadeshu Hamsanam Dhvanishu Asajyate Prapnoti. That those buds, how are they now? They have still not formed into the bud which can be eaten by the Annapakshi. It is still in an Arambha stage. So it is Kathoram. Kathora Varana Vadu. Gaja Vadhunam Danta Ankuram. So the young elephant's tusks have started coming up. And so it is competing with those tusks. Kamala Kareshu Bisini Kandagrim Granthaya. Evam Anyatra Vidisha Anaya Anusartavyam. So many descriptions have been of lotus stalks or even of lotus buds. But the ankuram or the starting stage has not been described in such a manner. So there is a beauty to the way he has described it. So avastha vedam. Choose. Desha vedatu nanatvam achetananam tavatu. Achetananam kathamasti desha vedam. Vayunam nanadikdesha charinam. Anyeshamapi salila kusumadinam prasiddhameva. So nana dikdeshachari vayu athena the devadaru ukshita devadaru kinnara geetikanam ayyo marandu vedutha ukshita the vayu. You know, different stage of Vayu can keep moving from different places. There are different types of wind. There can be a strong hurricane type of wind. There can also be a light, sweet breeze, right? Breeze and wind is different. So the breeze which carries the, in Kumarasambhavam, there is this description where Ganga is flowing and the breeze from there carries the, and then the nadila irukkakoodi and the thivilaigal eduthundu varudhu. The sprays of water sprays that are from the Ganga, a breeze which has these water sprays is so cooling to the effect, to the body. So Nana Digdesha. Never mind the Vayu which is just flows in the plains, but imagine the wind, the breeze that is there in the Kailasa, where Shiva is performing tapas, and it has Mandakini's waters in that breeze. So that is a different nanatvam, that is an apurvatvam that the poet has tried to give there. Salila kusumadinam, so different types of flowers, different water bodies like koopa adena vakyala konnu solvale canal dirghika koopaha nadi jalashayaha tadagaha. There are so many different varieties. If you want to see the description, read the description of nature, achetana description, no other place other than Bana's Kadambari. Kadambari is just filled with beautiful descriptions of achetana vastu. His power of observation is just beyond someone's imagination. The same time, you can also look at Sundarakandam, Champu Sundarakandam, where he describes the Ashoka Vanika, or when he describes the palace of Ravana, Esha Rakshasa Sarvabhoma Nagari, Rakshaschamo Rakshita, Tasyedam Sadanam Suvarna Shikaram Vidhanam Abhravali, Tasyedam Sadanam Suvarna Shikaram. Ravana's Malika, that Prasadam, his palace, has Suvarna Shikaram. It has peaks of gold peaks. And Vibranam Abhravalim, it goes and touches the, it doesn't touch. It bears the weight of the clouds, it seems. Vibranam Abhravalim, it has all the, it is the support for the clouds, the string of clouds that are there in the sky. Tatra Indudipa Kiranaihi Pradyotitasha Nisha. It is as if, you know, the night takes the lamp of Chandra. For night, the Chandra is the lamp for her, right? If you imagine if someone takes a lamp in the hand and keeps showing you, see, this is the Nagaram, this is where the army is protecting the nagaram, and this is where Ravana's palace is there. So that is the description he says. So yesha rakshasa sarvabhauma nagari rakshaschamo rakshita. See, the entire army of rakshasas are protecting it. Tasyedam sadanam suvarna shikaram bibranam abravalim. See, tasyedam sadanam, from dure he show the nisha is showing that entire palace. From a distance, slowly she is taking Hanuman towards Ravana's palace. So first she is showing the Nagari, and then showing that the army is protecting. Then she is saying Tasyedam Sadanam. This is the palace of Ravana. Suvarna Shikaram. Look at the Shikaram. It is filled with Suvarna. Vibranam Abravalim. Imagine the majesty of that palace here. Tasyedam Sadanam Suvarna Shikaram Vibranam Abravalim. Abravalim. I forget the third line always. Pradyotitasha Nisha. Indadeepa Kiranaihi Pradyotitasha Nisha. She shows this for him. So Achetananam api vastunam. So Desha Bedena, Desham, that is in Lanka. He first describes the Aranyakam, and then he comes to the all the forest description are over, Dandakaranyam and everything. Then he also describes, even inside Lanka, he describes the Prasadam, and then he describes Adena Ashoka Vanika, where there are a lot of trees and everything. So it depends on the place. Next is Chetananam api Desha Vedam. How is that Desha Vedam? Manusha Pashu Pakshi Prabhritinam Grama Aranya Saliladi Sameditanam. Adena Shakuntalatlurme Vanaukasam. Vanaukasamapi, how the mentality of people in the ashramavasi mentality will be very different from a person in the nagaram. So nagaravasi jananam krite, when they look at Dushyanta, they will only address him as king. They will never address him as vayasya. Whereas in the ashramavasi, the moment Priyamvada knows that Dushyanta loves her friend Shakuntala, Priyamvada will start addressing Dushyanta as Vayasya, friend. She will not say Rajan. That is the saulabhyam of an Aranyavasi. That is Desha Bheda. So Chetananam api Manusha, Pashu, Pakshi, Prabhritinam, all of these people, depending on where they are present. If they are present in Grama, it is a different attitude. Aranyam, Salilam, Saliladi, Samedhitanam, Samyuktanam, Parasparam, Mahana, Visheshaha, Samupalakshyate. There will be a great difference between even Pashu. Why? Shakuntalam is the best example for that. When Dushyanta comes to that ashrama, the deer, it is afraid of it. It doesn't expect a ratham to come to this ashramapadam. So it becomes very afraid and griva banga viramam muhur anupatati syandane drishtipataha. It keeps looking at the ratham that is following it. So it does not expect a ratham to come there, and so its behavior is completely different. Not the normal chanchalatvam, but it keeps running further and further away to escape from an unknown person who has entered the ashram. So the Desha Vishesham also matters a lot in the behavior of the animals. Takshana tatsannidhau vairaktyagaha. In Javali Ashrama, he will describe about how mriga shavakaha simhistanam pibati. A deer will drink milk from a simhi, from a lioness. See, that sannidho vairatyagaha. Everybody will forget their virodham, virodhitvam in front of a sage. Desha vishesha. The Mahakavi, the name Mahakavi will be given to a person who adheres to all of these and is able to produce an apurvatvam based on that difference. Let's go to the text. I'll keep on. Sahacha vivichya yathayatam upanibidyamanaha tathaiva anantyam ayati. Sahacha, that visheshaha, the desha bedaha, when you vivichya yathayatam, if you differentiate it properly, analyze it properly, and yathayatam, yathayogyam upanibidyamanaha, if it is used appropriately, you can produce different types of kavyas. Tathahi मानुषाणामेव तावत् दिग्देशादिभिन्नानां ये व्यवहारव्यापारादिषु विचित्राः विशेषाः तेषां केन अन्तः शक्यते गन्तुं विशेषतः योषिता योषित् बिकास् काव्यम् एण्ड् शृङ्गाररसम् इस् बेस्ड् आन् लेडीस् सो हि स्टार्ट्स् वित् दट् सो मानुषाणां फार् पीपल् आल्सो दिग्देशादिभिन्नानां दोस् हू आर् आल् इन् डिफ्रेण्ट् टैप्स् आफ़् देश एण्ड् दिक् इन् डिफ्रेण्ट् डिरेक्षन्स् व्यवहारव्यापादिषु हौ दि सि अदेन अन् मेगसन् देशत् लौरं when he is describing the grama taruni ladies who are in the gramam they will look at you so the yaksha tells the megham he says all those ladies you go and give them shade they will feel so happy about you about it and without any akapata drishtina விதவுட் எனி கப அந்த கபடமே இல்லாத ஒரு பார்வையால நேரம் உன்னை பார்ப்பாமா உனக்கு அனுகிரகம் பண்ணுவா மேகமே அப்படின்னு சொல்றார் சோ தோஸ் லேடிஸ் வில் லுக் அட் யூ விதவுட் எனி கபடம் விதவுட் எனி ஆஃப் தோஸ் அனபிஜ்ஞாக தே டோன்ட் நோ ஹவு டு யூனோ ஷோ த கட்டாட்சம் அண்ட் ஆல் தட் தே ஆர் வெரி பிளெயின் அண்ட் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் ஃபார்வர்ட் கிராம தருணி வெரஸ் வென் ஹி டிஸ்கிரைப்ஸ் உஜ்ஜயினி அது என்ன வஞ்சிதோசி If you do not go and look at that apanga leela of the ladies who are there in Ujjayini, vanchito asi, you will be cheated because there is no use if you have eyes, if you have not seen those ladies, because they are very chalu in their in the way they attract men. That is desha vishesham. मेघसन्देशम् अगेन् सो विचित्राः विशेषाः तेषां केन अन्तः शक्यते गन्तुं वि केनाट् सी दि एण्ड् टु द डिफ्रेन्सस् बेस्ड् आन् द देशविशेषम् एण्ड् दिक् एण्ड् एव्रिथिङ्ग् ईच् वन् इस् द पर्स्पेक्टिव् इस् डिफ्रेण्ट् द वे दे आक्ट् इस् डिफ्रेण्ट् एटिट्यूड् इस् डिफ्रेण्ट् वाट् दे आर् यूस् टु इस् डिफ्रेण्ट् संस्कारविशेषम् इस् डिफ्रेण्ट् विशेषतः योषिताम् उपनिबध्यते च तत् सर्वमेव सुकविभिः यथा प्रतिभा एस् हिस् क्रियेटिविटि विल् गिव् हिम् अ स्पेस् हि विल् यूस् इट् दट् इस् अ ग्रेट् पोयिण्ट् कालभेदात् च नानात्वं यथा ऋतुभेदात् ऋतुसंहारम् इस् एन् एण्टैर् टेक्स्ट् विच् विल् गिव् यू विच् इस् एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् दिस् उदाहरणं दिक् व्योम सलिलादीनाम् अचेतनानां ऋतुभेदात् when there is a difference in the season how is the sky sharad jyotsna shuddham vise there is megha avritam varsha ritu so that is a contributor for viraham it viraha uddipanaya we describe in the varsha kalam that the vyoma akasham is filled with megha and the varsha ritu is described in mrichakatikam in the fifth sarga The entire fifth sarga is the description of the Varsharitu. How he uses that Varsharitu to convey the love between the Vasantasena and Charudatta. He uses that Ritu Varnana, Kala Bhedam, to describe that. The same also in Meghasandesham or in Ritu Samharam, where he uses different states of the sky or this water and everything. It contributes a beauty. Achetananam. चेतनानां च कालभेदं कथम् औत्सुक्यादयः कालविशेष आश्रयिणः प्रसिद्धाः एव पर्सन् सेन्शियन्ट् बीङ्ग्स् औत्सुक्यं कालविशेषम् इम्प्लायिङ्ग् सो ए पर्सन् इस् नाट् देर् सो प्रोषितपत्रिका एषा नायिका सो शी हेस् टु वेट् फार् हिम् टु कम् हौ डस् शी वैल् अवे हर् टैम् in that mega sandesham and the irsha vipralamba shlokam varuve dhatu ragai shilayam because of that he wants to see adenama they both are separated from each other and he wants to look at her picture yakshi's picture and he tries to while away his time by drawing that picture but he feels so sad that by the time he wants to draw himself kritantah sangamam nau kritantah he does not want us to meet even in that shilapattakam even in that chitram he does not want to meet so that kala bedam because of that shapa hetu both of them are separated from each other he that outsukyam that is there in him to see a union between the two of them at least in the picture दट् गिव्स् रैस् टु दट् विप्रलम्बशृङ्गार तर्हि चेतना चेतनेषु कालभेदात् औत्सुक्यविशेषेण उत्पन्नः विप्रलम्बशृङ्गारः इट् केन् बि अ डिफरेण्ट् थिङ्ग् आल्सो वेरस् अदेन अगेन् इन् ऐ हेव् टु ओन्लि कोट् मेघसन्देशं वेर् शी ट्रैस् टु रैट् औत्सुक्यं मात्रं वाणुङ्गरद् इल्ल एनि एनि अदर् I'm just thinking of if there is any other example. Maybe later when I think about it, I'll say. So, Svalakshanya Vedate cha, Sakala Jagatkatanam Vastunam Vinibandhanam Prasiddhameva Svalakshanyam ityukte Swarupa Yathavad Varnanam. So, Swabhavokti. If you are trying to describe something which is its nature, Svalakshanyam is its nature. Based on the nature of each and every object, even mriga, for example, when we looked at that chamaryaha, langula vikshepa visarpisho vaihi, even there are different types of mriga. Please go and listen to Kumarasambhavam by Soti Nagarasharma Mahodaya. In this, for this shlokam, he will give you one recite from the Amara Paddhati, Amara Kosha. There are different types of mriga. Each one is different, right? The swarupam of each and every mrigam is different. And the deer that he uses particularly in Himat Pradesham is only chamari mrigam, where its tail is, the hairs of its tail are used for making the chamara. In particular, he uses that mrigam because it is not found anywhere else in the plains. It is only found there. The same way Krishna Sahara, he will use the Krishna Sahara for describing in the Krishna Sahare Dadat Chakshuhu in the Ashrama Padam. So that is a different type of mrigam. He will not use Chamari mrigam in Shakuntalam. Kalidasa will use Krishna Sahara in that. So that is Swalakshanyam, Swarupa Vedat. So Vastunam Vinibandhanam Prasiddhameva. It is popular only. I don't need to give examples, he says. Tacha Yatha Avasthitamapi. तावत् उपनिबध्यमानम् अनन्ततामेव काव्यार्थस्य आपादयति इट् कान्ट्रिब्यूट्स् टु अ यु नो वेरैटी इन् अ काव्यम् बेस्ड् आन् द स्वरूपम् दट् ईच् आब्जेक्ट् इस् एबल् टु गिव् अस् रैट् सो यु हाव् अवस्थाभेद देशभेदात् कालभेदात् स्वालक्षण्यभेदात् नानात्वम् अपूर्वत्वं च भवितुं भवति ओके I think we'll stop with this. Huh?